Hello friends, welcome to my channel Mechanical Engineering Classes. Today I would like to explain about the methods of transducers which will find the linear displacement. Okay. So the methods are for finding the linear displacement: LVDT method, piezoelectric transducer, photo emissive cell, photoconductive cells. In the last class I have explained this LVDT, linear variable differential transformer. This method I will give in description box this video link, so you please go through it. And next, today I would like to explain about these next methods: piezoelectric transducer. Before this I will tell what is displacement. Displacement means if we are taking any vehicle or object which is moving from one point to another point. Okay, so initially it is at A and now it is going at B position, like that. This is called displacement. So by using these transducers we can measure how much length the given object or vehicle is moving from one point to another point. It is called displacement. Now here we are using these transducers for finding the displacement in automobile vehicles, in two wheelers, four wheelers, and in some machines, and in some workshops, and in some laboratories. Okay, so this method, next method I am taking, piezoelectric transducer. In piezoelectric transducer we are using piezoelectric crystals. So these are the crystal name, and transducer means it converts input into output. Okay, so let us see in the process. This is the arrangement of piezoelectrical transducer. In it we are using crystals. These crystals we are calling as piezoelectric crystals, and here these crystals we are placing between two electrodes. Okay, these two are the electrodes, so between these two electrodes we are filling this gap with crystals. Okay, so initially there is no electricity. Okay, so in it, whenever we are applying some force on it, okay, so these crystals will compress. Okay, the crystals will compress, and then because of this compression, crystals will develop electric charge in it. Okay, this electric charge we can measure by using the output device, any output device at the terminals, output terminals. If you are connecting some voltmeter or ammeter, we can find how much voltage is developed because of this charge between two points in the output terminal. Now let us assume I am applying some force on this electrode. Okay, because of this force it will come downward and this crystals will compress. Because of this compression electric charge will develop. Because of this electric charge, or electrical potential also we can call, or voltage also we can call, this voltage we can find by using the voltmeter. Okay, so here the applied force, whatever force we are applying, is proportional to the developed voltage at output. What we can find by using this output voltage, we can find the magnitude of the force, how much force we are applying on the crystals. Similarly, let us take this is the first case. In next case I am taking in reverse order. Reverse order means, so I am not taking this force, I am not taking this force. Okay, this is the electrode. I am applying some voltage here, input. I am applying some voltage. Because of this voltage, this will change the orientation. Crystals will change, means it will take the electric energy. It will displace its position. Okay, because of this displacement, the gap will be more. Okay, so whatever gap is coming, so by using scale here, here one scale will be there. So how much force, how much displacement it has, or how much magnitude of force we can measure. Okay, so here in the second case we are applying input is voltage. Now whatever voltage is coming, it will give the force. So two cases we are seeing, this is force versus voltage, or vice versa. Okay, so by using this we can find the magnitude of force. Okay, and now if here in the first case we are taking unknown force, here unknown force, I don't know this value, I am applying here. Because of this application, electric charge will develop inside this. So this electric charge, or electric voltage, or electric potential, we can see at the output terminals in the voltage. So this is the method of piezoelectric transducer. Now where we are using this piezoelectric transducer? In automobile vehicles, and in as accelerometers. Okay, accelerometer means those will find the how much velocity vehicle is moving. Okay, per time. It is called acceleration. So in accelerometer, we can fix this instrument, small instrument, for finding the acceleration of the vehicles. And some pressure cells. Pressure cells means those will find the pressure. P means, here pressure means whatever force we are applying of this area, okay, per area. Now we can use in the pressure cells. Sometimes we can call it as force cells. Means we can find the force instead of pressure, we can find the force. Those are called force cells. And in accelerometer, already I told you. So we can apply in these cells for finding this displacement, acceleration, and pressure value and force value.